What's up guys, welcome to a new video on this channel. It has been a while since the last guide-like video, but as my Incineroar beginner's guide has been pretty successful and the option for Lucario won my recent poll on Twitter, here we are for the second bigger tutorial-like video on my channel. Before we start, let me tell you again that this will be a beginner's guide based on my personal experience in maining Lucario in Super Smash Bros. Ultimate, so you will surely disagree at some points. Also, I won't talk about too detailed things such as frame data, for example. Yet, I hope that this guide will help people to get a bit more into this character and more people start playing him. There will be chapters added so that you guys can hop to the points which are the most important ones for you. And now, with that out of the way, let's get into it. First of all, let's take a look at some basic information of Lucario. Lucario is a middleweight fighter, sharing the same weight as Wolf, Villager, Mithra, Steve and the Ice Climbers, which make Lucario part of the lower end of the middleweights in Ultimate. He has average height, a below average walking speed and an average running speed. His very high airspeed should be mentioned here, which lets Lucario gain access to a very good mobility overall, but we will talk a bit more about this later in this video. Also, Lucario can crawl, wall jump and wall cling. Lucario's most unique attribute is his aura ability, giving his attacks more damage output and knockback the more damage he received. But also the current stock situation or the current score in a time battle affects on aura. The aura multiplier in Smash Ultimate is at null 0.66 when Lucario is at 0%, so he only deals null 0.66 times of damage when he hasn't received any damage by himself yet. Another important factor is that the aura multiplier does not update immediately whenever Lucario's rank in a battle changes, for example, when he just took the stock lead. Instead, it will gradually scaling to the new value over a certain period of time. Explaining the whole formula would probably be a bit too much at this point, so I will show a part of his aura multipliers on screen and also leave the article to Smash Wiki in the description so you can take a deeper look at how aura works in every possible circumstances. Without further factors, Lucario reaches his base power in Ultimate at 65% of received damage, which means that the aura multiplier will be at 1 at these percents. He will reach max aura when he's at 190%, meaning that the aura multiplier will be at 1.67. While Lucario deals more damage and knockback, the more damage he received, certain moves such as Aura Sphere, Force Palm and Extreme Speed will gain more range as well. This benefits in both offensive and defensive ways, as while some attacks get more range, Extreme Speed allows you to travel further, which can help you to get back to the stage from further away. As this is supposed to be a beginner's guide, I will talk about low, mid and high aura to keep things simple instead of explaining the whole mechanic and every detail it has. We'll talk about how aura can affect on Lucario's playstyle later in this video, so let's move on with some of his combos. At low percents, Lucario has a great amount of pretty simple combos which can deal a good amount of damage. Most of them are based on moves like his neutral air and up throw. When being at low aura, Lucario can land many easy combos. While Nair and his up throw are two of the most common combo starters, Lucario can also use up tilt, forward air and an aura sphere cancel, for example. Cancelling aura sphere with using the shield or jump button is one of the most important things Lucario has access to, giving you the opportunity to start combos, take stocks or to make use of Lucario's incredibly good mobility. But don't worry, we will talk about this more detailed later in this video. On mid and high aura, some combos of Lucario change depending on your opponent's percents. However, if you are at high aura and your opponent hasn't received much damage yet, you can deal a good amount of damage real quick. Some combos may now contain less hits, but that doesn't really matter as you still will deal much damage within less hits because of aura. A very late up tilt into up air, for example, could even take stocks when your opponent has received enough damage. All in all, Lucario's combo game is very solid. With neutral air he has access to a very safe move which can work as a good combo starter and lead into tech situations on higher percents, which, on the other hand, can be punished as well. With up throw, Lucario also has access to a good combo throw, at least when the opponent hasn't received too much damage yet. Down throw can work as well, but the more reliable option is his up throw. So as we talked about some of Lucario's combos, let's take a look at his actual key moves. Say, attacks which have a great use in battle and which give you a good amount of options. As I already mentioned Aura Sphere cancelling, let's start with Aura Sphere. But what exactly makes Aura Sphere as good as it is? First of all, on high aura it can become a very dangerous projectile which can take stocks, but more important is definitely the fact that you can use Aura Sphere not only in an offensive, but also a defensive way. And how does that work? Pretty simple. Lucario's Aura Sphere charge can be cancelled with using Jump or Shield, for example, which gives you the opportunity to either immediately follow up with another attack or to keep on moving away from your opponent, for example. If you use the shield button to cancel Aura Sphere while playing with the GameCube controller, let me give you a tip. I've sent my shield button to Y, which allows me to cancel the Aura Sphere charge fast enough, as the window for cancelling Aura Sphere with shield is about 3 frames long, if you want to follow up with another attack immediately. You can see that your timing was right if the shield animation is never visible after you cancelled Aura Sphere charge. As this can already be very useful, there are other techniques which can change your movement with using Aura Sphere charge completely. Of course, I'm talking about B reverses and wave bounces. These allow you to completely change your movement during Aura Sphere charge, which can either give you the best possible position to go for an attack using a follow-up after an Aura Sphere cancel, or can help you to avoid your opponent's attacks because they make your movement absolutely unpredictable. With both B-reverse and wave bounce combined with Aura Sphere cancelling, Lucario gets an insanely good mobility, which, in my opinion, gives him a huge advantage over many characters of the Smash Ultimate roster. Changing your movement can help you getting into a good position for an attack or dodging your opponent when he's trying to hit you. As already mentioned, Lucario's Aura Sphere cancel allows him to immediately follow up with another attack, which gives Lucario some very useful confirms, which either can deal much damage or even take stocks at higher percents. The second key move which I wanted to talk about is Lucario's neutral air. As you could have seen in some of the combos, Lucario's Nair is an incredibly good combo tool. But not only that, combined with a fast fall, Nair can be incredibly safe on shield, which also can give you an advantage in terms of movement and reaction, as your opponent probably won't be able to punish you after shielding against your fast fall Nair. Also, at higher percents, Lucario's Nair can lead into tech situations which can be punished as well. With Aura Sphere and Nair, Lucario has two major key moves in his kit which can give him so many advantages and options during battle. In my opinion, mastering the character does also mean to master these two incredibly useful attacks and every relevant options they can include, such as B reverses, wave bounces and Aura Sphere cancels for Aura Sphere, and every possible combo follow-up and fast falling for neutral air. So after all that, let's take a look at some of Lucario's biggest advantages and disadvantages. Personally, my biggest pro for Lucario is his incredibly good mobility. Yes, I already mentioned that multiple times, but it is a fact. With B reverse, wave bounce and Aura Sphere cancel, you can have access to many great opportunities to either confuse your opponent with your quick movement or to take stocks with using an Aura Sphere cancel follow-up. Another good pro is his combo game. Many of his combos are pretty easy to execute, which can help you to deal damage real quick, even if you are at low aura. When being at high aura, you'll get the opportunity to deal an even bigger amount of damage fast by using simple combos including Nair, up throw and up air, for example. Talking about damage, in my opinion the aura mechanic is also a major pro, as it can make the character unpredictable. You know the saying that it's not over until it's over, and a high aura Lucario is a force to be reckoned with. Everything's possible, even turning around games which seem to be already lost. One major con: Lucario still has his weight. Especially compared to Smash 4, Lucario got much lighter, which can cause that especially more unexperienced players have trouble with staying alive long enough to make good use of the aura mechanic. Against characters which can kill early, Lucario struggles a lot. It's surely not impossible, but you'll probably need some time to get into the character and his gimmick so that you can manage to reach and stay at high aura for as long as possible during every match. Another con I would mention is that some of Lucario's moves either come out pretty slow or still can be a bit unreliable. Even though both of them got already buffed in the past, I'd say Force Palm and Forward Tilt still do not work as they should sometimes. Especially Force Palm Grab can be frustrating to use, as it is a common follow-up option for an Aura Sphere cancel against shielding opponents. All in all, Lucario is a very underrated, technical and difficult character in my opinion. If you want to master the character, there are so many options which you have to get into. His mobility is outstanding, he can edgeguard pretty well, has a simple combo game and some reliable combo options, and he's absolutely unpredictable thanks to the aura mechanic. Especially for beginners, it can be a challenge to get into the character, but with enough practice it should be no problem. Also, I hope that this guide could give you an overview of Lucario in Smash Bros. Ultimate so that your start with him becomes a bit easier. If you have any questions, then let me know in the comment section. Thanks for watching, and as always, don't forget to leave a like and subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye!